Can I have a skin graft after scalp cancer? I had a large skin cancer on the top of my head that was removed and a skin graft was taken from my thigh. I also had to undergo 30 days of radiation. I have a crater on the top of my head due to this. Could it be possible to have hair replacement therapy or anything to help hair grow there?
Thank you for your question. So you're asking about the ability to actually have a hair transplant in an area where you had cancer on the scalp. And in addition to that, you had radiation. Well, the short answer to the question is that it is possible to actually transplant hair to skin that has been grafted. And essentially, what we have been able to do in a lot of people who have had scars, burns, and have successfully been able to transplant hair without too much difficulty. But when there is a history of radiation, there is always a concern about the blood vessels or vascular supply and whether it'll be adequate to be able to support hair follicles. So, you also mentioned, or it was seen in your photograph, that there's an indentation there. And there could be some what's called fat atrophy or volume loss from the radiation or from the excision of the cancer. So since I can't do a physical exam, I would consider some different options as far as trying to give you hair back into that area. For one thing, we can also treat potentially the indentation by something called microfat transfer. But it depends a lot on the quality of the skin and whether or not it is stuck down to the skull or if there's a lot of scar tissue, it may or may not be practical. Something that we could also, we would also do in our practice in our surgical hair transplant practice, which we do routinely, is we use a material called extracellular matrix that has been developed by a company called Acell. Now, this is a material that is derived from the bladder of pigs, and it has a series of proteins, and it's called a scaffold, that has been used to help restore wounds, particularly open wounds from in the military from war injuries. And I've had the pleasure of using this material for the past several years, both for my surgical treatment of hair loss, but I am a board certified cosmetic surgeon specializing in both facial and body, breast, and extremity surgery. I've actually used the same material for several of my cosmetic surgeries as well as my reconstructive surgeries. And in a world where there's a whole lot of people claiming miracles, I have to say there in so many ways this is quite impressive how well this material is able to regenerate tissue. The concept is that when we use this material, instead of healing by scarring or traditional healing process, the body sends adult stem cells that heal by duplication of the natural tissue that's supposed to be there. So if it's skin, it heals with skin. If it's muscle, it heals with muscle. If it's hair, we're seeing increased hair growth. So what I would probably do after a physical exam is consider just doing a test session, where we would take a few hairs from the donor part of your scalp, using in combination with this extracellular matrix and with very good microscopic surgical technique, place a few hairs, maybe 100, 200 hairs, and see how those hairs grow. If they grow and they do well, then I would have more confidence about doing the procedure so that you can get some coverage. You can't get the same as you had before you lost your hair, and it appears you do have some male pattern hair loss besides having the scar or the skin graft. And so we have to be strategic. You have a limited number of hairs, and we have to use them strategically. But I think that the stepwise approach and the use of this very new and advanced regeneration concept of adult stem cells using extracellular matrix can probably be your best bet at chances of success if you were to consider having the transplant. So I know this is new information for you. Please do the research. I hope that was helpful. Thank you for your question.